Radio Deftones. El radioactivo.
Así es, muy buenas tardes. Están los Deftones aquí en la cabina. Hi guys.
What's going on?
Hello, we're live on the air. How are you?
Wow, we're great, man.
How did you find Mexico City so far?
It's wonderful, man. Yeah. That's all I can say.
How was the show? How did you thought about the show last night?
It was a beautiful show.
Yeah, it was good.
It was good, man. I mean, anybody that was there, they know.
Yeah, I was there.
You were there?
Then yes, I know. I enjoyed it very much. But I was impressed about the way all the people knew all the songs.
Yeah, of course. You know what I mean? Like, we've been doing this for a lot of years, man, and a lot of years these fans here in Mexico City have been with us, man. And they know that. And they know that we have known they've been here. And we're ready. We're ready. We're finally here, and we're ready to, you know, have fun with everybody and enjoy Deftones music all together.
Le preguntaba a Chino acerca de qué tal le encontraron en México. Dice que está muy bien. Porque está ayer, dice, cualquiera que haya estado ahí anoche sabe cómo estuvo. Le preguntaba si le había sorprendido la reacción de los fans. Me dice que es normal, que ellos ya tienen mucho tiempo tocando y que los fans estaban esperando a que vinieron. En fin, what do you want to play first, guys? This is your radio show. Do whatever you want.
Well, considering that we are so fresh and we are
damn clean,
we want to let you on a little stank onia. Turn it up, we gotta hear it loud.
La primera canción es Outcast, del disco Stankonia. So fresh and so clean. Estamos aquí con los Deftones. Esta es su estación de radio. This is your radio station, guys. I'm just doing the translation. I'm going to ask a couple of questions that the fans have sent us through the email.
Right,
vamos a hacer preguntas que han hecho los fans a través del email. Esta dice, this one says, congratulations, you inspired me a lot. You're different to other bands and apports a different view and a way to the hardcore stuff. My question is, what do you think of death metal and which band are your favorites? Including Thrash, Grindcore, Death.
Oh, man.
Alex.
Meshuggah, I think, is one band, like, as far as, like, just hardcore.
Sugar?
Just riff metal. Meshuggah, yes, is a band. I think all of us, as a band, love. As far as, like, old stuff we grew up listening to, man, I liked a lot of, Suicidal Tendencies and stuff like that, you know. Death Angel, I don't know, man. But recently I got into King Diamond. I like all stuff, man. I like all music. And as far as, you know, is that concerned? Stefan, you want to talk to him because he knows some heavy shit.
A ver, I'm going to translate. Chino dice que le gusta Meshuggah. That's the name. I got it right.
Mm-hmm.
Y que de chiquito le gustaba Suicidal Tendencies. Y que últimamente, what's the name of the band you said you were into lately? Ah, King Diamond, no?
Yeah.
For Merciful Fate. He was in Merciful Fate, right?
Yeah.
I used to listen to that when I was young.
And Possessed, though. Voivod, all that
yeah.
shit.
And you, what about the question this guy made?
I like stuff like Napalm Death, Morbid Angel, stuff like that. Carcass, they're pretty crazy, for sure.
Cannibal Corpse.
Han mencionado, pues yo estoy oyendo a Cannibal Corpse, a Carcass.
Meshuggah. Brujaria.
Muchos grupos.
Fear Factory.
But I don't know. I think some of your fans consider Fear Factory kind of soft. You know, they like harder stuff.
They're harder than Fear Factory?
Yeah.
Shit.
Yeah, that's different.
Okay. What are you going to play? You get to pick the next song.
This next song is by Meshuggah and it's called Future Breed Machine.
Ah, pues ahí está el grupo del que tanto han hablado, Meshuggah, para todos los fans de Deftones.
Oh, yeah.
Radio Deftones. El radioactivo.
Bueno, pues estamos aquí en la cabina de Radioactivo 98.5 con los Deftones. Vamos a estar más o menos intercambiando un poco el micrófono entre Rulo y una servidora. Bueno, recibiendo los mails de las personas que están teniendo la amabilidad de acercarse por este medio para llegar a los Deftones y obviamente de esta manera hacerles algunas preguntas. Estaba platicando ahora fuera del aire con Chi. Le dice que si realmente cuando viajan en sus giras, cada uno lleva sus discos, y me dice que sí, que no hay otra manera de hacerlo más que haciéndolo así, porque si no, pues tendrás que estar condenado a escuchar más o menos lo que está ahí sonando. Y le dice que hay algunas bandas que igual sí prefieren descubrir un poco lo que está pasando en la radio local. Y sí me decía que, bueno, que para él eso no es a veces pues, muy bueno, porque como que siente que la radio local generalmente nunca toca lo que se oye realmente nacional, digamos, ¿no? Ya les dijimos que a ver si más a ratito buscamos algo de música nacional, pues para que puedan tener una muestra de lo que se hace aquí en nuestro país. So, she, I know you have like this spoken record, you know, and the fans were wondering if they could have this record, if they could buy it yesterday, you know, in the concert, but as it was like impossible, I wonder if you could share with us a little of this, you know, as an exercise, what you have in your spoken album, a bit, yeah?
Sure. Unfortunately, I couldn't bring the spoken word album into Mexico because of all the red tape and restrictions, and that was kind of a drag for me because I'm, you know, I think it would be good for people to hear, you know. I think that all of our side projects, that we all take the same integrity as we have with the Death Zone, you know. So, spoken word, I would have to say, Gantini, Holinga, Mohonai Pinyao, Mohongoi, the Mexican people, Holinga, and Mohosheng, Chek, Wangkongwa, and Dajani, Mohosheng, Dajan.
¡Wow! Les vamos platicando, Chi, que si fuera tan amable de compartir con los fans, que sabemos que tiene un disco de, pues, de, digamos, de poesía, que es un disco hablado, que sabemos que siempre lo lleva a sus conciertos y que en sus conciertos es donde lo venden, pero que igual ayer hubo gente que estuvo preguntando que igual dónde pueden conseguir el disco y como estaba platicando que fue muy difícil para él poder estar cargando con el disco, pero que es un proyecto que tiene toda la integridad que igualmente tienen los Deftones, como de todas las personas de los Deftones que tienen sus proyectos aparte. Y entonces, con todo gusto compartir unas palabras, las que menos entendimos fueron las que compartieron que, obviamente con el público radioactivo. So it's your turn for one song, no?
This is my Valentine song for me and Chino.
Sinead O'Connor, escogida por Chi en Radioactivo 98.5, su canción
love
del día de San Valentín. Cheers.
I love it.
Radioactivo es Radio Deftones. Deftones.
Ah, we were in heaven, no? With that song? Perfect. Okay, Chino, what can you tell us about... This is a question, you know, from a fan, Carlos Ramirez. He's asking, what can you tell us about your side project, you know, Team Sleep? And how far you're thinking to go with that project?
Team Sleep is something that I've been working on for a long time. It's been very hard to get enough time aside from being a part of Deftones. But all the time that I've had, I've been working on it lately, and it's a project that's very mellow and ambient. It's where basically a lot of my influence has been coming from lately, just like very lo-fi, just electronic, like very organic, moody, lovely music.
And the opposite from Deftones.
No, I think Deftones has a lot of that in it. It's just an extremity of it. You know what I mean? Deftones has a lot of beauty in it, and although it may be heavy, I think it's just something very like exciting and new and. That's what this project is. It's just not, you know, heavy as far as like being very loud and abrasive. It's very warm and exciting. And right now, Stefan's holding up CDs to me, and I'm getting excited. I mean, we need to keep listening to music because I'm so happy right now.
Ok, le estamos haciendo una pregunta que mandó Carlos por correo electrónico, que es deftones@radioactivo.com.mx. ¿A dónde ha preguntado que él puede decir, Chino, acerca del proyecto alterno que tiene de los Deftones, que se llama Team Sleep, que hasta dónde piensa llegar con este proyecto? Chino contesta que es un proyecto que lleva mucho tiempo en el que está trabajando, pero obviamente, pues como está el mayor de los tiempos con los Deftones, no le ha podido dedicar todo el tiempo, pero que básicamente este otro proyecto lo complementa porque es música que es mucho más, ¿cómo decirlo? Pues mucho más melodiosa.
Más sutil, más atmosférica, más electrónica, más orgánica. No tan diferente a los Deftones, que los Deftones también tienen de repente eso, ¿no? De
uh-huh.
Sacaron el disco de The Cure y se emocionó mucho. ¿Qué, who's gonna play the next song?
We're going to...
I think it's me, I think...
We have to go, you know?
Commercial.
But we're back, ¿no? Vamos a un corte comercial, venimos con una canción que va a escoger en este momento Chino. Estamos en Radio de Tons, Radio Activo 98 y 5.
Radio Activo es Radio de Tons. Tons. Radio Activo.
They told me that the classics never got a style, but they do. They do. Somehow, baby, I never thought that we do too.
Cinco los Deftones completitos están en la cabina. Here's a question, another question from the fan. This is from Pablo Corone. Una pregunta de Pablo Corone. Do you plan to come back to Mexico in your next tour?
Definitely, man. I mean, we wish we could have came here before now. You know what I mean? We've always craved to come here, and it just seemed like it was no better time than to come here. You know, a few months ago we were talking about, we were like, man, we need to go to Mexico, because what happened was we were on a U.S. tour. And every time we'd be like, you know, in Southern California, like San Diego, or like, you know, South Texas or whatever, we'd have so many fans coming over the border from Mexico to see us, and like, you'd be like, you don't understand. And in Mexico, you have such a following. We were like, man, we need to go there so bad. And I've always wanted to come here for personal reasons, anyways. And it's beautiful, man. You couldn't ask for anything.
Definitely be back though. Yeah.
Well, yeah, we'll be back. Don't trip.
La pregunta es si piensas regresar a México. Dicen que sí, definitivamente, que cada vez que tocaban en el sur de California o en el sur de Texas había muchos fans mexicanos que se cruzaban la frontera para saludarse y decir, tienen que ir a México, ahí hay muchos fans. Pues bueno, ya están aquí. Además, Chino quería venir por razones personales. You said Chino last night that you were proud to be Mexican after the
show. Hell yeah, I'm proud to be Mexican.
Estás orgulloso de ser Mexican. How Mexican are you?
I'm pretty fucking Mexican, I'll tell you that.
Es muy mexicano. You speak Spanish, no?
¿Qué? Yo no sé, ¿qué?
Ahí está, se habla español, ok, perfecto. Bueno, what's next, guys?
What's next?
Sí.
Dropping bombs all over the earth. For real.
Who chose the next song?
You? Steph won't tell us.
You don't want to tell, ok.
So it's a surprise.
Vamos a escuchar, sorpresa.
Who chose this hit? Radio Deftones. Radioactivo.
This is the dawning of the age of Sirius.
Ahí estuvo Iron Maiden, que causó controversia. That was a controversial song. Iron Maiden.
Yeah, that song's pretty long. Dude. I don't know.
How many covers have you played live lately?
Seven. It really doesn't matter. We just go out and between songs sometimes we'll just start playing one. We don't even really pay attention to it. We don't plan it.
Which ones do you remember playing lately?
Lately we've been playing some
of course the Weezer song.
Yeah, we've played some Weezer, which is just one of our favorite bands, period. We love Weezer. Suicidal Tendencies, Slayer, you know, whatever. Whatever comes to Depeche Mode.
Fighters.
Les preguntaba que qué cosas han tocado últimamente. Me decían que cosas de Wizard, de Depeche Mode, de Slayer. En fin, what are you going to play next? Whose turn is it?
Yeah.
You again?
Okay. Little Cricket.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Little Cricket. We're about to slip into some darkness over here, all right?
Yeah.
Y les vamos a hacer rápidamente una pregunta, porque lo que ellos quieren es irse rápidamente con música, más música y más música. Entonces, vamos a preguntarles, you know, when you're on tour and you're on the road, do you have this kind of problems on choosing who's going to pick the next song or the listener you're going to listen to?
Yo, more money, more problems. Yeah, the thing is that we love music so much, each of us individually, and we like a lot of the same things, but we like a lot of the same things at different times. We're just like a married couple.
We get around to all of it, though.
You know, we do get around to all of it. And right now, you know, yeah, I was pretty mad on the Iron Maiden. I was kind of like, come on now, you know. I like Iron Maiden too, but I don't feel like hearing that right now, you know what I mean? But like, I'm just one voice in this band. And the rest of the band, they wanted to hear Iron Maiden, so long live Iron Maiden.
I respect, yes. Okay, Chief, it's your song, so why have you choose this song?
This is the greatest pop song ever written.
Dice que, bueno, les contamos anteriormente que cuando están de gira en el camino, cómo le hacen para no pelearse de quién va a poner tal, no la vamos a escuchar tal. Dice que, pues básicamente que no hay problema, que tienen muchos gustos diferentes, pero que en el momento pues ya pueden respetar perfectamente, como en este caso no quería escuchar mucho chino Iron Maiden, pero ya después dijo, bueno, ¿por qué no? Larga vida Iron Maiden. Y ahora lo que vamos a hacer es escuchar una canción que ha, bueno, puesto el ojo sobre ella este Chi. Le preguntamos que por qué escogió la canción que vamos a escuchar a continuación, y dice que porque es la mejor canción de pop escrita en todos los tiempos, y es esta.
Radioactivo es Radio Deftones.
¿Qué tal el equilibrio, de lo rudo al cielo, del infierno al cielo, del cielo al infierno, del infierno al cielo? Ya estamos de regreso. So you've been touring a long time, you know, and you have shared the stage with different bands. Yes. Which is like the act that has surprised you the most?
I don't know. I liked a lot of the bands we toured with, but some of my favorites have been the Bad Brains. We got to tour with them, who have been a band that influenced us a lot throughout when we were young.
Barbra Streisand.
Pantera.
But we never toured with them. They think bands we toured with.
Oh, I just rent Yentl a lot.
Come on, get it together. Let me think. What bands do you like? Quicksand.
Yeah, Quicksand,
the band
Far,
we all love.
Had a lot of fun with Far.
Far is a great band. I mean, Korn, we've toured with them from the beginning of time.
The beginning, not now.
Now, we haven't toured them in a long time, but I will tour them again. I don't care.
Yeah, right.
Okay, les preguntamos que
your parents.
Se han ido de gira pues mucho tiempo. ¿Con qué bandas han compartido el escenario que les han gustado mucho? Nos mencionaron ya, como escucharon, un sinfín de bandas, rescatando por ejemplo algunas que pues quizá aquí no son muy conocidas y otras que son influencia para otras bandas como Bad Brains. También estuvieron haciendo gira con Corona. Se platicaba que al principio pues era algo que les gustaba mucho, que lo volverían a hacer. Quizá ya no es como todo lo que más les guste, pero han compartido el escenario con muchas personas. Which is the next song?
I think it's Pumpkin Song.
See, the thing is, we're not really knowing what's going on because we're in here battling on what the next song's going
to
be.
This
next song, we know it is from Smashing Pumpkins. We don't know what song it's going to be off the album Gish, but this album inspired us like a motherfucker. Let's listen to that shit right now.
Don't.